إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My dear brothers, please sit down and don't exceed the rules. Sit down, جزاكم الله خيرا. It's not allowed to exceed the rules during khutbah. جزاكم الله خيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. My dear brothers and sisters, last week, last khutbah, we tried to speak about Al-Ayn, the evil eye, and its effect and influence on people. And usually, in most of the things in our life, people have two extremes on the most right and the most left, and Islam come to give the balance in the middle. As we mentioned, that some people, they disbelieved in the effect of Ayn. Some people, they do not accept that Ayn can have a physical effect on the human body. Ayn can have a big effect on hearts, emotions, and even the mind. Ayn can have very strong effect till it can affect people to die. On the other hand, these people who do not believe in any of that and they just believe in the reports of medicine, they just believe in the new knowledge of the non-Muslims, they don't believe in the authentic ahadith, they don't believe in the ayat in the Quran, they don't believe in that, وَلَعَالُ بِاللَّهِ. And some extremists, they believe that everything in life is related to Ayn. Every problem happened to them is due to Ayn. And every single sickness or illness or trouble is due to the effect of Ayn. Two extremes. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified and explained and gave us the clear treatment. The second group who are exaggerating too much in the effect of Ayn, they are so afraid and worried from the effect of evil eye. They might leave some actions in front of people because they are worried from the evil eye, and they go to other extents that will reach shirk. والعياذ بالله. قال الله جل جلاله: وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. And we send down from the Quran which is healing and mercy for the believers. Healing for everyone, even for disbelievers. And mercy only for the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down this Quran and it has real cure and treatment and healing for the hearts and for the physical diseases. That's why it was narrated as in Bukhari and Muslim that one day the Sahaba with the accompanying ship of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, they were traveling in a trip and they reach a people, and you know in the past there is no restaurants, no supermarkets, so they requested them to treat them to have some food. These people, they refused, they rejected, "We will not treat you." And by the destiny of Allah, the chief of these people, the disbelievers, he was stung by a scorpion and he was totally paralyzed, no movement, totally sick. So they went to the Sahaba and they said, "Maybe we can find the treatment or cure with these foreigners." They requested the Sahaba, "Can you treat our chief? Do you have any type of treatment?" The Sahaba said, "We can. Wallahi, we have cure." Abu Musa said, radiallahu anhu, "But with condition. You give us a wage for that, because you refuse to treat us." So they agreed, "We will give you a flock of sheep if you could treat our chief." So Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu went and he put his hand on the place of the stung of the sting of the scorpion and he recited Surah Al-Fatiha 7 times. Immediately he was cured. He stood up and he was walking as if he has nothing. Then they gave them the flock of sheep and Abu Musa radiallahu anhu told them, "We will not divide it until we reach Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam," and tell him the story. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he heard that, he asked Abu Musa, "Who told you that this is ruqya? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ أَنَّهَا ruqya?" And he was so happy and surprised by the knowledge of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam agreed on the wage they took from the non-Muslims and he said, "اضربوا لي معكم بسهم," and also give me a portion from these sheaves as type of confirmation for what they did and what they took. So here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed and confirmed the action of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari that he did ruqya for a physical disease and not normal sickness. It is a bite of a scorpion, and you know it is deadly bite. With Al-Fatiha 7 times, totally cured, mashallah. The effect of the Quran, the words of Allah, the Almighty. As well, it was reported by Anas radiallahu anhu in Bukhari Muslim that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam رخص في الرقى من العين والحمى والنملة. Anas radiallahu anhu mentioned that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam allowed, gave permission to have ruqya from al-ayn, the evil eye, the influence of the evil eye, والحمى, the bite of the scorpion or the snake, والنملة, the pustules come in the side of the body. So Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم gave permission to have ruqya for these three. As well, it was authentic hadith عن عائشة رضي الله عنها, as was narrated in Sahih Muslim. قالت أمرني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن أسترقي من العين. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered me to have ruqya, to use the ruqya
from the evil eye. So look how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us, my dear brother and sister, to have ruqya. The Islamic ruqya and the satanic ruqya. We have the pure ruqya, the allowed ruqya, and we have, wal'ayadu billah, the polytheist ruqya, or the satanic and devil ruqya. The scholars, they say, the ruqya should be from the Qur'an and Sunnah, nothing from outside the Qur'an and Sunnah. And it should be in Arabic language. It cannot be by any other language. And it should have the tawakkul upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that nothing will affect unless by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And any unknown ruqya, any unknown words, any ununderstandable sentences, that is clear shirk. One day, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he entered his house and he found on the neck of his wife Zainab, he found a string on her neck. He asked, "What's this?" She said, "Someone did ruqya for me and I hang it." He said, "Antum ala Mas'ud la'aghniya 'an ash-shirk." You, O family of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, you don't need to have shirk. Then he took it and he threw it. He cut this string. And then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud told his wife, "But you have to know that Rasulullah said, 'Inna tama'ima wa tiwalata shirk.' Indeed, this amulet is considered as shirk." And one day, Jibreel alayhi salatu wassalam descended to Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. فقال يا محمد أتشتكي؟ فقال نعم عليه الصلاة والسلام بأبي وأمي. Jibreel came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day and the Prophet was ill. He asked him, "Do you feel ill? Do you feel sick? Do you feel pain?" The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Yes, I feel it." So Jibreel عليه السلام said, بسم الله أرقيك من كل شر يؤذيك من شر كل نفس أو عين حاسد الله يشفيك بسم الله أرقيك. That is in Sahih Muslim. That Jibreel عليه السلام is the first one to teach the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم while he was sick how to have the ruqya. He said, بسم الله أرقيك, in the name of Allah, I'm giving you the ruqya. من كل شر يؤذيك, from every evil may cause you or affect you. من شر كل نفس, from the evil of every evil soul. أو عين حاسد, or the evil eye of any envious person. الله يشفيك, Allah is the one to cure you. بسم الله الرقيق, in the name of Allah, I'm giving you ruqya. My dear brothers and sisters, no exaggerations. There is effect of عين, yes. There is effect of حسد, yes. There is effect of magic, definitely, yes. And the recent medicine, they don't understand what is magic and they don't believe in it. If you go to the top hospitals in the world and someone is affected by magic and they will do all the diagnosis, all the possible check for his body, and they will say it has nothing, then they will just go for the mental illness. Because they don't believe in the effect of magic and the effect of evil jinn on the human body and the effect of the evil eye. But we Muslims, we have the revelation from Allah Jalla Jalalu about the effect of magic, and we have the cure. And we have the revelation from Allah about the effect of عين الحسد, and we have the cure and treatment. الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام والتوحيد, الحمد لله على نعمة القرآن والسنة الحمد لله رب العالمين. أقول ما تسمعون، ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده النبي الأمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى صحابته الغر الميامين ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، some people out of fear and worry, they rush after just any strange effect or some sickness they found in their children, in themselves, in their wives, that they are not stable, that they are not normal, they will quickly run. Unfortunately, to the magicians, they will quickly go to what they call them future tellers. Future tellers, the kahin, arraf, they will go to those who are claiming we have spiritual effects. We know the unseen, we know what you don't know, we see what we don't see, and so on. And it's enormously spread in the Muslim world. Unbelievable to find a Muslim when he has a trouble. Big trouble between him and his wife. Sickness for a long time, he cannot cure it for himself or for his children. Then they will take that person to those weird people. And unfortunately, they will do weird things. They will do a lot of haram things. And they will do a lot of shirk. And the Prophet ﷺ made it clear, مَنْ أَثَى عَرَّافًا لَمْ تُقْبَلْ لَهُ صَلَاةٌ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةٌ. The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, whoever just visit, we're not speaking about believing now, just a visit, just, let's see what he will say, just visiting and let's see what is the knowledge of these people. What is the cure they have? Just visiting a future teller or fortune teller. The Prophet ﷺ said, just a visit, 40 nights, his prayer will not be accepted. 40 days, all your prayers are not rejected. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. How about if someone believed? قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ أَتَى عَرَّافًا أَوْ كَاهِنًا فَصَدَّقَهُ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ. In this authentic hadith الذي أخرجه الحاكم وصححه والذهبي وافقه والألباني, that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever visits a fortune teller, then he believed in what he said, then that person disbelieved, he had kufr, for the revelation came down on Muhammad. فَقَدْ كَفَرْ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدْ. Just to believe these people, it's a major shirk. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. وَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّ التَّمَائِمَ شِرْك. أو قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, مَنْ تَعَلَّقَ تَمِيمَةً فَقَدْ أَشْرَكْ. Whoever hangs an amulet, hangs on his neck, hangs in his car, hangs on the wall, a blue eye, a five hands amulet, a blue hand amulet, to have protection and shield from evil things. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام, فَقَدْ أَشْرَكْ. He committed shirk, he committed polytheism. And by the way, the scholars, they said these five
Originally, it's from the five ayat of Surah Al-Falaq. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. Then people assume that Shaitan deviated people to shirk. They just believe it's a five hand. It will protect you. And then they just had this belief in the blue color that it will make a shield and protection from the evil things. And they will hang on the necks of animals, in the cars, children, this shirk to protect them. Believing that this can make an effect. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarified, that is shirk. At-tawheed is number one, number two, number three, number 100, in the beginning, in the end, in the middle. Without tawheed, no jannah. Tawheed is very sensitive and very pure thing, and any black thing will affect it. Be careful, my dear brother, my dear sister, for this shirk which is spread in the Muslim world, unfortunately. That people, out of the fear, they go and ask haram things and shirk things to protect them from magic, to cure them from the destroyed relation they have between husband and wife. Someone, he is loving someone, and he wants this another gender to love him. So he will make, well, a'yadu billah, this amulet, or this, go to this fortune tellers to make something to strengthen the love. And so that is shirk, pure shirk of jahiliyyah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our hearts from the shirk. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts by tawheed. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purify our homes from shirk. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to follow the steps of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the evil eye, and from envy, from hasad, and from magic, and from evil souls, from jinn and humankind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us to be protected by His protection. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us His own special protection. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها زكاها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم أصلح لنا ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي إليها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم اشف مرضنا ومرضانا وجميع مرضى المسلمين. اللهم ارحم موتانا وجميع موتى المسلمين. اللهم نفس كرب المكروبين من المسلمين واكشف هم المهمومين من المسلمين واقض الدين عن المدينين من المسلمين. اللهم فك أسرانا وجميع أسر المؤمنين. اللهم كل إخواننا المستضعفين من المؤمنين والمسلمين في كل مكان برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أذن لهذه الأمة أن تعود. اللهم رد الأمة إليك ردا جميلا. اللهم رد هذه الأمة إليك ردا جميلا. اللهم ردنا إلى الكتاب والسنة وارزقنا العمل بالكتاب والسنة وارزقنا فهم الكتاب والسنة. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشرك. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشرك. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الشرك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار.